and thanks for joining us. Trade Partners and Caspian have come together. It is a joint venture to provide you with an end-to-end solution in launching your brand and selling your products on over 25 marketplaces in the US, including Amazon and Walmart. तो हमने देखा है कि बहुत पेन पॉइंट्स हैं, जैसे पिछले सेशन में भी डिस्कस हुआ था, जैसे IOR सर्विसेज, एडवर्टाइजिंग, कैंपेन्स, काफी कॉम्प्लेक्स हो सकता है ये अगर एक मैनेज सॉल्यूशन नहीं हो. तो वी विल टॉक अबाउट दिस. आई एम ऋषभ गुप्ता, को फाउंडर ऑफ ट्रेड पार्टनर्स, जॉइनिंग यू फ्रॉम मुंबई, एंड वी हैव कुणाल चोपड़ा, सीईओ ऑफ कैस्पियन, हु इज जॉइनिंग अस फ्रॉम सिएटल, यूएसए. Caspian is a NASDAQ listed company and among the top 25 sellers on Amazon US with over 4,000 clients, 7 lakh reviews and a sales of a whopping 7,000 crores. So, inki company ne kareeb 7,000 crore ke sale already kiye hue hain. Together, we will simplify selling in the US for you.
Excellent. Well, I'll take it over then, Rishabh, from here on. So, nice to meet everyone. I'm Kunal, as Rishabh mentioned, CEO of Caspian. So I want to really start by telling everyone here that e-commerce is booming in the US for third-party sellers. And I want to show you some data to prove my point. You can see here clearly that, you know, US consumers are predicted to spend almost $700 billion in e-commerce in 2020. The COVID pandemic has truly accentuated some of the growth that we did not expect going into this year in e-commerce. In fact, this year, we would end the year at about 18% year-over-year growth, which is going to be one of the highest in records that we have seen since 2008-2009. So the situation when it comes to e-commerce in the US is very good. Overall, consumer spending has been shifting online more and more. And this has really happened because of the COVID pandemic that we saw this year. In fact, this chart really explains to you the distribution of where sales are coming from all of retail. You can clearly see that spike that we saw in Q2 of this year. In Q2 of this year, the total distribution that we're seeing from e-commerce has accentuated in a big way relative to what we have seen in previous years, relative to overall retail sales. Brick and mortar obviously has been closing down. Work from home orders are in place. People are shifting online a lot more, and that's seeing this surge in e-commerce sales that we haven't seen before. So what are some of the big drivers of the e-commerce surge? Well, we obviously know that Amazon is one of the big drivers, but we cannot discount some other marketplaces as well. Amazon continues to hold a large portion of the overall market share in the US, but there are some other marketplaces as well, like Walmart is certainly doing a lot of work when it comes to e-commerce as a whole. They also have an advantage in the sense that they can combine a complete omni-channel experience with all their different stores that they have, along with their online experience. They can create an advertisement platform that surges across both their online and offline experiences. eBay, Home Depot, Wayfair, Best Buy, Target, all these are formidable players in the top 10 marketplaces. No doubt Amazon leads the way, but we can't discount some of these other players as well. But I also must tell you that the market is competitive. As you can see from this second slide, there are tons and tons of sellers that are selling online. They're selling both here in the US as well as globally. In fact, the number of sellers that continue to come online regularly has been increasing year over year. More importantly, if you see that chart on the left, in the bottom left, you'll see that the top sellers on the platform make a extremely small amount in the number of sellers that actually drive a lot of the revenue are numbered very small. So all the bulk of the sellers are really on the left-hand chart of this diagram that you see here. Something to pay attention to. So the small players aren't really doing too well on the platform. The big players are doing really well on the platform and are driving a lot of the revenue in the platform. So to really succeed on the platform, you don't need to be able to have an edge relative to all these different players. All the things that the Amazon contact that, you know, gave the previous presentation talked about, all the different things that you should be paying attention to when it comes to selling on the platform. You know, how do you do that? Caspian and Trade Partners provides that entire suite of software and services to help you build your business on marketplaces such as Amazon. Amazon is also a growing advertisement platform. If you take a look at that chart on the right there, you can see that it's, you know, the top three platforms out there in terms of market share. In fact, we have data to show that almost 60% of product searches on the internet start on Amazon, especially in the US, which means Amazon is able to capture the consumer from the first time they're trying to search there, from the first time they're trying to search for a product online. And so you can see that increase in the market share that Amazon is gaining when it comes to advertisements relative to even Google. And Google has actually predicted, it has been showing a sort of decline in its market share as it relates to advertisement as a platform. So it's a core reason that for you as a seller, when you're selling online, especially on Amazon, you've got to take into consideration a comprehensive advertisement strategy. Now, Amazon sellers have needs and wants. It's very clear that to succeed on a platform such as Amazon, to succeed on a platform such as Walmart, you have to do business differently than what you've done before. You've got to think about pricing. You've got to think about ratings and reviews. You've got to think about your listings. You've got to think about managing inventory. You've got to think about fulfillment. You've got to think about the health of your account. And when we surveyed a bunch of different sellers, we've got over 4,000 in our catalog, as well as some of the survey results that you see here, it's clear that sellers need help to build their businesses online. And it, going on your own is a difficult task to do because you've got to think about all these different things, and they're very different from how you would typically operate as a particular seller. So it's critical that you try to think about all these different aspects of running your business on a platform such as Amazon relative to how you've done business before. So I'll hand it over now to Rishabh to talk about how can you take advantage of the opportunity, the growing e-commerce market of the US, but also in a market that seems to be pretty competitive.
Thanks, Kunal. So I think the important question here is that there are many, many brands from across the world who have successfully launched their business and are selling in the US. The burning question is, why aren't you doing it? Ki aapko kya rok raha hai from launching your business in the US? Can we get the next slide? So the typical markup on pricing that we've seen for our clients between selling in India and the US is between 2 and 7x, which was also discussed by the Amazon representative in the previous slide. We've seen that the margins that you can expect in the US are much, much higher. Anyone can start selling in the US. So you don't have to worry about being a manufacturer or a trader, being a big brand or a small brand, or being from a big city or a small town. Again, which was seen in the previous presentation, that a lot of sellers are actually coming from the smaller towns and are doing exceedingly well in the US. All that you require is a vision and experienced partners who have over a decade of experience to represent you and do justice to your brand in the US. Can we get the next slide? So from the time that you produce your products to the time that your products are sold in the US, we will partner with you to provide you with an end-to-end managed solution. Hum aapke saath wo puri journey tay karenge, just right from the time aap produce karte hain to the time your customers receive their products, and the complete selling journey is complete. So let's start with what are the services. So we will be your importers in the US as the IOR. We know that IOR se related bahut questions the, and we solve that big problem by being the IOR. So we will first start with a viability assessment of your products, which again is a big problem. Kyunki naye sellers ko malum nahi padega ki unke products ki viability kya hai. It is difficult to do that analysis sometimes, and again our tech will enable that. We will create your listings including A+ pages. So listing create karna bhi Amazon USA ke liye kala hai, kyunki काफी कॉम्प्लेक्स हो सकता है यूजिंग द राइट कीवर्ड्स एंड यूजिंग द राइट लिस्टिंग्स. A+ पेजेस, वी ऑल नो द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ दिस. इट इज योर ओन ब्रांड स्टोर ऑन Amazon. सो द इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग हियर इज दैट वी विल बाय योर प्रोडक्ट्स ऑन कंसाइनमेंट बेसिस. आप डायरेक्ट Amazon को नहीं भेज रहे, हम आपके प्रोडक्ट्स बाय करेंगे. वी विल एडवाइज यू ऑन लेबलिंग एंड कंप्लायंस. अगेन अ बिग पेन पॉइंट कि आर योर प्रोडक्ट्स कंप्लायंट इन टर्म्स ऑफ लेबलिंग. अगर आप फूड कैटेगरी कर रहे हैं तो क्या आपका FDA registration चाहिए नहीं चाहिए, what kind of products require this registration. We will also manage all freight documentation and custom clearance. So again, a big pain point which we solve. we use our own warehouses near Seattle to store and distribute your products. So हम outsource warehouses को आपके products नहीं देते, हम खुद अपने warehouses में store करते हैं, giving you that cost advantage. And from here we will either fulfill the products to our to your customers, or then we will redistribute to Amazon if we want to go down that route. Again, it depends on cost optimization. We leverage our team of over 155 members in Seattle and our technology to enhance your sales on the marketplaces and social media. So we offer you a full suite of services. We will manage feedback and reviews. Again, एक बहुत जरूरी चीज है feedback and reviews को manage करना, customer service को manage करना. We will reconcile your accounts and provide you weekly MIS reports. Again, कि आपका कितना बिक रहा है, क्या आपके account में पैसे आए हैं in our account, which we will then remit to you. We will manage returns, again, which was spoken about in the last slide, कि अगर liquidate भी करना है, what is the right price? We will maximize all of that for you. We will take care of all US taxation. Again, a big point to worry about, क्योंकि US में local taxation हर state में differ करता है. And as a corporate, we will take care of that for you. आपको इसकी कुछ चिंता करने की जरूरत नहीं है. And the big one, we'll provide you with any RBI paperwork that you may need. तो RBI से हर compliance हम आपका पूरा करेंगे. आपको सिर्फ export करना है. So as you can see, this is a complete and a comprehensive solution, which is end-to-end to launch your products and to sell your products in the US. To get started, you only need an import-export code, which is a simple application online, and you can get your code the same day. So, एक बहुत simple application है import-export code obtain करना, और आप किसी भी शहर से, किसी भी town से आप exporter बन सकते हैं. For those of you who don't have it, we are happy to help you with this solution as well. So, often people ask कि इसमें आपके fees क्या हैं, और is there an onboarding fee? So, I think the important thing and the very exciting thing out here is ki hum kuch onboarding fees charge nahi karte hain. We align ourselves with you. Aapki success mein hamari success hai, and we don't charge any upfront fee. Hum aapke listing vagera sab create karte hain. Aapka cargo hamare containers mein jayega. Our containers sail every 2 weeks to Seattle. So we are trying to solve many problems which sellers face in exporting their products to the US. We give you a full end-to-end solution. Kunal will walk you through the next few slides.
Great. So as Rishabh mentioned, you know, we as a joint venture together with Caspian and Trade Partners, you know, just to give you a little bit of our history as well, we've been selling on Amazon specifically for almost 12 years. So once, you know, we've got tons of experience overall when it comes to selling on the platform. We've done, you know, almost $1 billion in sales on the platform. Our positive lifetime rating is 99% on the platform. You know, once a brand or a partner like yourself comes onto the platform, we have seen an increased lift of almost 60% in revenue over the first few months, in the first 3 months. Our renewal rate is 100%, and we save, you know, brands like yourselves, traders like yourselves, tons and tons of hours of work as we are a complete managed solution to help you build your business online. And really our philosophy is we take a people first approach. We want to find partners. We don't want to find customers. We want to find partners. We want to work with you, help you build your business online, specifically on all these different marketplaces. And our business model is built in a way that is really aligned to you, as Rishabh mentioned. And so our view is really to help scale as you scale. Here's another thing that I'll mention is we take a tech first approach to doing everything. So our business, like I mentioned, started 12 years back, and we have built all our technology in-house. So right from inventory management to pricing, to managing your channel, to auditing it, to help you scale on from it when it relates to, as it relates to advertisements, we have built all that technology in-house. So we really consider ourselves a services and a software company at some level. And here are some of the statistics that you've seen with some of our software. And what we have done is we've also now commercialized our software. So for sellers who want to take that operation in-house and want to build and manage their entire operation in-house, we have taken parts of our entire technology stack and we have now opened it up to the world. So we have ad management, we have brand and seller monitoring, Amazon cost recovery, different tools to help you build your business online. And Very soon, we're launching all these different tools that you see here for the Amazon.in market as well. So, you know, as we get that to market, we will definitely keep everyone involved. But as of now, we have access to a bunch of different tools that we've built in-house to help you scale your business online. So that's kind of it at a high level. We'll certainly open it up for questions, but the way to get in touch with us is really just email business@tradepartners.us, and that's our phone number as well there. And, you know, we can get started right away.
Thank you, Rishabh, and thank you, Kunal. Those were some really amazing insights on cross-border selling. I'd like to call in Mr. Mubashir for the Q&A round.
Thank you, Anubhav. So I'm back. Hey, Kunal. Hey, Rishabh.
Hello.
A couple of questions coming in for you both. So the very first question which I would like to take up is, undoubtedly that you really have got, you know, a lot of things to offer to our existing customers, which will not, which will actually make their life easier and very simple, right? And they need to just focus on to their core competencies rather than running from pillar to post, arranging different stuff, arranging for the export license, or maybe you know, the other legal formalities that need to focus on others on nuances. Yeah, so we need to keep it strictly in English. So बहुत सारे sellers हमारे ये जानना चाहते हैं कि आपका percentage क्या है? Are you working on a profit sharing model? Are you working on some fixed commission model? How you are working? That is first part. And second part is, do you share losses also?
So we basically work on a consignment basis. तो हम import करेंगे आपके products और जैसे-जैसे बिकेगा माल, जैसे-जैसे products बिकेंगे हम आपको वैसे-वैसे remittances करते जाएंगे. So if Amazon settles with us every 2 weeks, you will have the remittance in your account in India, completely RBI compliant on T+2. So the moment Amazon gives us the money, we remit it to you within 2 days. Your first question, so like I mentioned, we don't charge any upfront onboarding fee. We align ourselves on your sales. So we take a percentage of your sales that are generated on Amazon. This varies across product categories, and we are happy to look at every client in a very unique manner and align ourselves ki jaise aapka revenue grow hoga, waise hamara fee model scale hoga. The idea is that how do we help you sell more, and in turn we will reward ourselves for the work that we are putting in for you.
Sure. So one more question coming up. So people are also interested to know whether you are doing the reverse of it. If somebody from US wants to sell in India, then how you are helping them, and is it possible to do it?
Yes, absolutely. So we are offering the same model to US customers as well, where we become the importers in India, and then we periodically remit funds to the US as well. So it's the exact same model. Our strength is US and India, and between these two countries, we offer our services.
Sure. So maybe it can be a sales lead for you, but let me still pose it to you. So they are existing sellers, rather they are existing exporters. Their products are completely dumped, and they are actually very, you know, blocked due to this lockdown. So can you help them there? So can you pull them, those products to your warehouse, keep it and sell it, and can share the profit?
So where are the products right now?
So I guess this is a question from Sandeep Menon and Arsh and many more. So I guess it would be great if you can share your email ID over the chat room so that they can get in touch with you in person. And then you guys can take it forward.
Yes, absolutely. Our email, the email ID is mentioned, and I will again post it online on our chat, and you can send me your questions.
Sure. So people wanted to know, if they are completely new and they would like to offer your service, they'd like to go for your service, then in how much time they'll be able to make money, and what is the minimum, you know, CapEx which is required to sell in US. That is the second part of the question. And the third part of the question is, and how about the cost per impression, or maybe how about the advertisement cost which is aligned, and in what ratio they should add up to the product cost?
Sure. So let's go one by one. There is no minimum order size that you need to export, right? This is your business. You decide what is the value of consignment that you wish to export. The benefit here is that all your cargo will get consolidated in our containers. So you're not paying the high air freight through FedEx or UPS that is required to send your product to the US. We give you the advantage of ocean freight and the fact that we have full containers going off multiple sellers. We give you that cost advantage, which is almost 1/5 to 1/6 of air freight. That is an advantage that you have. Again, like Kunal mentioned previously, advertising is a very important part of selling in the US. So for every product category, we will come up with an advertising budget, which will be on approval from you. And that's how we will start pushing your products. AdWords, keywords, product titles, again, become very important in terms of how we optimize your listings. And we have a team in Seattle, and we have got every category almost has its own team. So there's a lot of data and insight which we thrive on, which we have collected over the past decade that we've been in existence to help you optimize your sales and maximize your product's reach to your customers.
So one last question, because time is not permitting us to take more. I would humbly request you to please answer those questions live, maybe over the chat room or within the Q&A section. Last question is, do you limit any consignment size, or maybe are you, you know, getting into an agreement for X number of months and years that the parties should be, you know, they need to take it for X number of months, and is there any time limit to it, or maybe if it is, then what are the exit clauses?
Sure. So I'll give a really simple answer to this, that you stay with us for as long as you want, for as long as your motive is being served, for as long as your objectives are being served, you stay with us for as long. There's no lock-in. At the end of the day, we want to promote good business practices. And as long as you're happy, you can stay with us. If you're not happy, you can switch out of our services and we can close out very quickly. Like Kunal mentioned, we've got a contract renewal rate of 100%. That's the kind of confidence and value add that we have been providing to our customers.
Good afternoon, everyone. It is our pleasure to talk to you this afternoon, and I welcome you all to the massive world of e-commerce. So we are excited to be part of this event of Unicommerce, where the e-commerce selling is our number one priority. So we will cover our presentation in next 20-25 minutes max, and we'll cover the topic like cross-border e-commerce trends and the COVID impact on the logistics and the cross-border e-commerce, and some of the DHL proposition built based on the cross-border e-commerce perspective. So I'll post this presentation. I hope we'll enable to sell e-commerce like we have sold never before. So to start with, if you all remember how many devices were online in 2016. So it was around 16 billion online in 2016. And when we moved to now, so it is 26 billion now. So this is sort of growth what we are looking at here in e-commerce. So e-commerce is growing faster than any other channel for retailers and manufacturers around the world. So, and this growth is expected to be at around 75 billion by 2025, which is around 62% since 2016. So around 26 billion of devices will shop for the product worth around 6.5 trillion by 2023. And according to the e-commerce trend report by 2020 by Unicommerce, online retail focused technology platform e-commerce not only recovered but also witnessed a very high growth of about 17% by H1 2020. So this sort of growth we are looking at from the industry. And while it is known fact that the retail transactions are likely to slow down with the closure announcement of big retail chain like Zara, Oasis, Galleria and Kidston, this retail business is expected to be converted to e-commerce business, and which augments very well for our e-commerce industry vertical. And hence this is the time to get into it. And if you don't get into e-commerce cross-border now, so you won't find a better time than this, what we are trying to tell you here. So some tips from DHL. Clearly communicate any impact of this situation, COVID-19, on your homepage. This is the study done by the agencies. So I'm showing you some of the example. Clearly communicate the clear message on your accepting orders, your processing orders, or your shipping orders. So this is very important to get into it. I'll move to next. So how DHL is responding to it? If you look at, we had initial challenges on sending shipments, supplies to various countries initially when situation were unfolded over there. So DHL Express actually supported really well customer, and we were able to deliver some of the critical shipments of our customers well in time in this COVID-19 situation. So the safety measure what we are taking here is we have the COVID-19 task force in place. Our people are opening service centers in phases. Like we have around 3 large service centers in Bangalore, for example. So every service centers opens in phases. Service center having a mask, gloves for all the employees, and we are ensuring sanitizing of our vehicle, our facilities on very regular basis. And we have developed some of the method where we can deliver our customers e-commerce shipments without contacting them. Yeah, so demand from the new market is expected to grow and increase. And what we are trying to show you here is it's not only electronic and fashion. A whole lot of product finds opportunity of cross-border e-commerce kind in this market. So a lot of growth available for all product. If you look at, have drawn an average growth of about 25% year on year. And as per the Google Consumer Barometer as well, all the BRIC countries, so Brazil, Russia, India, China, India is also a BRIC country. They are buying fashion product from abroad. And even in DHL, what we saw in India, consumer buying product abroad, though we have the quality of the product available within India and the pricing available within India, but it's still people are buying from abroad. So I'm assuming a lot of here on a call already doing cross-border e-commerce, and we'll tell you some of the innovative solution which can really power up your cross-border e-commerce business. And before I get into the proposition, I'll just show you why premium shipping is must do in cross-border e-commerce. So if you look at, as per the research, some of the data says you have 60% of growth in case of you have the premium shipping option. 70% of your sales cart value increases if you have the premium shipping option. 91% of shoppers, they leave the website if they don't find the premium shipping option available in the website. And 45% of shoppers, they get into the cart, and the moment they see the delivery options, premium delivery options not available, they leave the site and move from the site. So DHL offers, DHL is one of the company who offer the premium shipping, and premium shipping is must do in the cross-border e-commerce. While you have a fancy product listed in the website, you have a fancy website, fancy payment gateway options, but the product delivery to your end customers can really screw up your happiness. And DHL offer the premium shipping option. DHL can deliver your shipment anywhere in the world within 2 to 4 working days. And that is very, very fast. And as a shipping option, premium shipping option now very extremely important to give as an one option in your website is must do for DHL for cross-border e-commerce. So with one DHL account number, you can start trading with 220 plus countries. So the moment you account sign with DHL, you can trade with 220 plus countries. Our pricing is built in such a way so you can trade anywhere in the world. And we have our own aircraft. We have our own super hubs across the region. We have 100,000 plus employees, direct employees handling your shipments. And we have 43 quality control centers where we monitor the quality and the transit time of your shipments. And we are moving nearly 493 million shipments per year. So this is sort of business what we are talking about. And this, when you work with the companies like DHL in this COVID situation, where I think local player may not able to help you out in terms of reaching your shipment faster to your customers, DHL plays a very important role. And hence you have to be work with the company who is established across, and you have infrastructure across to help you out. Yeah, why critical? Final mile delivery is very critical in e-commerce cross-border. So some of the research, as per various research on e-commerce, clearly says 20% of recipients' delivery fails on first attempt, and 37% of recipient receiver, they blame you for the poor delivery, and you end up paying the refund to your end customers. The last mile delivery can directly impact your business. Irate customers write nasty review on the website. You end up giving a lot of returns and you have the loss of customer risk as well. And why this is happening? The root cause of this is always a consignee not found at home. He's not available at home. Incomplete address. And consignee shifted to the other address. These are the major reason why the final mile delivery fails. And we have a product mainly keeping in mind the COVID situation as well. This product is we can deliver your shipment to your end customer without contacting them. So how we can do that? So what exactly, if I remember the count right, out of 220 countries we serve, ODD, no contact delivery, is live in 150 plus countries. And it is an automated system where your customer can choose the various delivery options. If you look at here, he can schedule a delivery. He can ask us to without signature delivery. He can ask us to leave to their neighbor. He can collect the shipment from our customers near a service point, and he can give us alternate address. For example, to take example of India, let's say I'm in Bangalore and for some reason I'm traveling to Mysore and I want shipment to be delivered to Mysore, we can do that. And some of the customers go on vacation hold, so they can ask us to hold the shipment for 7 days, 14 days where we can deliver the shipment. So this sound really very simple, but when you have to move millions of shipments every day across the world. So to put up a system like this and make it as simple as it is today needs a lot of thinking and efforts. And we have done it for your customers. So your customers getting the benefit of better experience, lower return rates, and lot of delivery options, better delivery options available for the end customers. So another benefit of the ODD feature is you can enhance your brand value. You can have your company logo in our DHL notification, which is going to customers. So this is look like this way. So one of the example I'm showing here of Fab India. So notification also can go to customer like this. So I'm moving to the next proposition of DHL. So many a times when we ship a shipment to USA or Europe, for example, we move 40, 50 or 100 shipments. So I assume I am a shirt supplier and I get an order for 100 shipments on a daily basis. So what I do, I'll move one shirt, then I'll move second shirt, then I'll move third shirt. So what exactly I am doing? I am preparing 100 shipping document on a daily basis, and I am moving 100 shipments on a daily basis. And what I do, I pick up all these document and go to DGFT or a bank and ask them to settle my refunds and issue a BRC from the bank. So suddenly when the number of transactions goes up and you find it difficult to handle, how to bring this down, these numbers. So you can think of like sending a shipment together and delivering within the region like USA custom union. But when you are moving a shipment together, you need somebody over there. So let's say you have a friend and you want to send a consolidated shipment to your friend. But how will he break it apart and how will he distribute across the USA? So deconsolidation and delivering and domestic delivery is very high in place like US and Europe. So maybe if you still have a person, how will you manage an IOR? If you get an IOR, maybe your relative or your friend to whom you can send the shipment. But when you are moving a shipment in a consolidated manner, you end up paying a duty because the overall value of the shipment goes above the de minimis cost and you end up paying the duty. So, which is right. So how to manage this? That's how I think hybrid came into picture, where I can pick up your multiple shipment under one single mother invoice. I move it to my nearest gateway for a clearance under one single mother invoice. So let's say I pick up 50 babies of your shipment, 50 individual babies. I consolidate all of them in one single mother, move it to custom clearance port at Bangalore, for example, and clear the shipment in a mother invoice. And after the clearance, I can move your shipment individually to the destination. I can move your shipment as a consolidated also to a destination. So once your shipment reach at destination, let's say, for example, of US Custom Union, I clear your shipment in one shot. I can clear your shipment individually also. So when I clear your shipment individually, you get a benefit of de minimis. Your all shipment, which is below $800, for example, USA, $800 is a de minimis for USA. I ship clear your shipment individually without duty and deliver to end customer. Wherever your invoice value to individual customer is more than $800, I pay duty and deliver to your end customers. And that's how we deliver to your end customer. So the feature of this product is I can move your shipment in a baby WPX type, and I can move your shipment without palletization or with palletization both. I can pick up your dutiable shipment and non-dutiable shipment under one mother invoice. Transit time is faster because post clearance in India, shipment will move just like a normal WPX, a sample mode. And then this we can set it up for you for any country subject to the approval. You need to let us know in advance and we can set this process for all the countries. The benefit to you is you are saving cost in terms of destination warehouse, in terms of manpower, because you don't have to depute a person to prepare 100 shipping documents on a daily basis. You save the cost for clearance because in origin, we just clear under one mother invoice. So you don't have to pay the clearance charges for each and every baby shipment. Faster GST refund because this shipments are moving in a cargo mode and the data is visible to the ISGATE and the EDP EMS and DGFT IGST tool. So your GST refund is faster. So you don't have to block your capital amount. And then you can also avail any of the government benefits because we give you complete shipping documents. So this is how we can move your shipments. And this is how customer gets benefited out of this product. So hey, I'm moving to CSB.
So we just we are over with our presentation slot, but still you can, sum it up in one or two slides and then one or two quick questions can be taken. Hope that is fine.
I'm moving it. Done. So another is CSB5. So most of our customer, we are sending shipment, which is low in value, below de minimis under a courier mode. But courier mode is meant for the samples and the prototype. So CSB5 is one tool where you can move your shipment in a courier, like a courier mode, because in courier you get a faster transit time, but you are not getting a benefits, government benefits. But in cargo mode, you get benefits, but slower. But CSB5 give you best of the both. And the benefit of CSB5 is you get refunds, uplift same day, faster transit time, and very minimum paperwork. So this is the compliant way of moving shipment. Today, customs is very strict post-COVID because tax revenue is low, and they are looking at compliance of your shipment, and CSB5 is the compliant way of moving shipment. You are selling on a marketplace, you are selling on your own website, you are selling on a platform like Shopify. DHL can integrate all of them. So we have plug and plays available where we can just plug it and start working within 2 to 3 hours maximum. So our partners like Unicommerce, Shopify, or Magento, we have an API available where we can integrate all of them. Today, regulation is changing every day post-COVID. If you look at India, shipment coming from China takes need to go through a lot of regulation and a lot of restriction. So customer service of DHL can give you answer what paperwork, what is the regulation of that country, and that they can help you out 24/7. And you can reach out to them for any query which is related to your shipments. And I'm just closing this presentation with giving you the contacts of our regional business development managers. So Gaurav Pasi, Prem Dash, and Rahul Thampi, they are regional business development manager based out of their location in Bombay, Delhi, and Bangalore. So you can reach out to them for any help which I presented today, any of the feature, any of the proposition you are planning to work with us, you can reach out to them directly. So I'm leaving you with this contact details of my colleagues. If any question, I have a time, so I love to take a questions and answer them. Or you can reach out to any one of them on these email IDs or my email ID. We love to answer them.
Thank you. Thanks a lot, Ammar. So, Ammar, we have got 3 minutes. So let me pose one or two questions. So the very first question which people are looking forward to know is about the RTO. How you're going to manage the RTO and the international fairs. And in addition to this, they wanted to know, is there any, you know, reverse shipping fees which is required, or maybe are you helping out in getting those products liquidated? And do you have got something related to where, you know, something related to fulfillment channel, or maybe are you working as some 3PL partners, or maybe you are integrated with some 3PL agencies which help them to scale their business there and then?
Yeah, thanks, Mohammed. So based on our experience in cross-border e-commerce, most of our customers, first, what we have observed, no one would like to get the shipment back into the country, because the one of the reason, because you end up paying the freight charges plus the duty is very high in India. So most of the customer, they actually don't look at this option, but still with DHL, you can have an import account number and we can bring your shipment back. You pay duty and clear the shipment. Another option, like we can have a customized solution for our customers with our partners, with our sister companies like DHL Global Forwarding or DHL Supply Chain. We can look at an option of storing the shipment in the warehouse and delivering to the end customers. But those are case to case basis. But currently we are not offering any ready reckoner, ready services for returns. But yes, we can give you the import account number. You can import your return shipment through that import account number into India.
Sure. Second question, people want to know, is there any minimum shipping requirement, or maybe is there any minimum shipping load what is required, and how you are going to settle the discrepancies between the overcharge and getting it, you know, overpaid, finally ending up with, and how you're going to, you know, solve that remittance?
Yeah, so in DHL Express, as I said, like we have the regional BDMs, the email address shared with them. So you don't have any minimum requirement from DHL side. So shipment volume of below 50 shipments in a month, or plus 50 shipments a month, or 100 or 500 shipments in a month, up to 2000 shipment a month customer also we have. So you can work with us in terms of getting a remittance. As I explained, the CSB5 shipping tool. So through CSB5, you can move your any of your shipment, e-commerce shipment, and DHL give you, as a facilitator, will give you the shipping bill copy of those shipment, and with those shipping bill copy, you can have your all refunds, all the claims, government benefits, you can withdraw through the shipping bill copies of DHL.
Let me quickly take the last question. Do you have a warehousing solutions in US, and do you do the sellers need IEC code for that?
If you are working on a international movement, IEC is must for all the movements, even from India or from the warehouse in US to the end customer. But warehouse DHL Express as an entity, we don't offer, but we have a sister company, DHL Supply Chain. With the help of our sister company, we can set it up for you if you need a warehouse in the place like USA or anywhere in the world.
So we are, giving one more minute extra, in which we have already covered 30 seconds. So a quick question. So in one DHL account, can we operate on, maybe it can cover all the accounts of sister concerned companies, your own DHL logistics, shipping, international and domestic logistic accounts? Everything can be managed under one single app or maybe one single login. So it can be termed as a master login. If yes, then what all can be covered under that?
No, Mohammed. I think we have four large companies in India: Blue Dart, DHL Express, where I am representing, DHL Global Forwarding, and DHL Supply Chain. So all of us work differently, and we need to have a separate account number for all, because just to identify a shipment moving under the network of DHL Express or DHL Global Forwarding, so account number is a unique number to identify the shipment is for which services. So we need to have a separate account code for all this, but it won't take much time. Within a day or two, or max to max 48 hours, we can set up an account with all the entities together for our customers.
Hi everyone, my name is Kavish. I am a part of the Payoneer team, and Payoneer is basically a cross-border fintech company working with sellers across the globe. So today, in today's session, while I'm going to talk about what Payoneer can do for your cross-border e-commerce business while you sell from India into different marketplaces, I'm also going to talk about what the opportunity is like for Indian e-commerce sellers when they sell cross-border. in my professional experience at Payoneer, I have me and my team have worked with dozens of sellers, hundreds of sellers from India who sell cross-border. And we have also understood a lot of problem points when it comes to selling cross-border. So I'll quickly walk through of what we can do as a platform, what we do as a platform, what the opportunity is. And then I look forward to questions from each one of you, and we'll request all of you to make maximum out of the session you are going to attend now. So just to give you a background, Payoneer is basically a cross-border payment solution. We help companies of all shapes and all sizes, be it a small SMB seller operating from a remote town in Rajasthan to a large seller selling on their Shopify store in the US. We help companies and businesses of all shapes and size to sell cross-border and to receive their payments from marketplaces and B2B clients directly. So we work with 4 million customers, 2,000 plus marketplaces, we support 100 plus currencies, and we have offices across the globe, and we allow SMEs to accept payments from 200 plus countries. So we basically understand cross-border e-commerce. So we understand what are the problem areas, what are the pain points, what are the barriers to scale, and how a small and medium-sized business from India could grow their cross-border business, not just in India, but to every other geography in the world. So you could be based out of Udaipur selling leather bags, and your customer could be based in Australia, your customer could be based in Singapore, your customer could be based in New York. You could be a leather seller, you could be a home and linen seller from Indore selling in the US, you could be a personal care brand selling from Gurgaon to anywhere in the world. So we help you accept payments from all the marketplaces like Amazon, Walmart, etc. Also from payment gateway solutions like ToCheckout, Stripe, etc. on your Shopify or on your... So let's talk about what the overall opportunity looks like. So if you look at last 6 months, they have been really challenging for each one of you. Even for us, we have to work from home. Even for you as a seller, it's a tough time to get your employees to office, to maintain the hygiene standards, and to make sure that the infrastructure is as supportive as it was pre-COVID. There have been challenges in logistics not going on time. There have been challenges with Amazon not accepting shipments on time. There have been challenges with limits that Amazon has recently put on FBA everywhere in the world. So last 6 months has only been challenging. And what we have learned is while there are challenges, the opportunity is also increasing. So if you just look at this presentation, it very clearly indicates that in 2014, around 20% of the people, 23% of the people were buying goods from sellers who were based out of their home location. For example, a seller in the US, a customer in the US buying a good from a seller based in UK or in India or in Bangladesh, for example. If you look at 2020, close to 50% of the 2.1 billion online shoppers will be buying from global websites. So that clearly indicates that there is plenty of opportunity for Indian sellers to cater to needs of international customers who are buying goods from sellers globally. So what we have done is we looked into the Amazon Seller Digest 2019, a very popular report published by Amazon every year. So when you look into that, clearly looking at the e-commerce play, there were 50,000 sellers last year who sold their goods cross-border. There has been a 56% growth in the number of exporters that were selling from India. And these 50,000 sellers collectively offered a selection of 140 million products across the globe. Isn't that massive? Isn't that a lot? It is already happening from India. In the US, the top five categories are home decor, health and personal care, books, beauty, apparel. Taking a deep dive into what home decor is, home decor would have everything from double bed sheets, cushion covers, blankets, etc. Health and personal care could be reselling brand products, could be selling your own personal oil brand, for example, or a personal beauty care brand. And a lot of homegrown brands from India are already seeing success in the US and in the EU. So My overall objective here is to explain you that there is enough opportunity for sellers from India to be able to sell cross-border. So if you are already selling domestic right now, now is the time to go cross-border, and now is the right time to expand. If you are already on Amazon India, now is the time to expand to global selling from Amazon US. If you are already selling on your Shopify store in India, now is to start sell cross-border and work with international and sell to international. So, very interesting presentation. It's basically a mirror into what is happening right now. So, we looked into the IIFT report, which is a report from 2017, a very interesting report on potential of e-commerce of e-commerce for retail exports from India. So, a traditional MSME or an exporter from India would export to 3 to 4 economies or geographies, whereas e-commerce firm of the same size could be exporting to 30 to 40 geographies. That's like opening wide from 3 to 4 to 30 to 40 geographies from India. If you look at the business survival rate, this could be subjective information. Again, but it's the source of the data is an IIFT report. Traditional MSME businesses have a 30 to 50% business survival rate after the first year, while an e-commerce exporter is 60% to 80%. So what does this indicate? This indicates that digitization is the key to success right now. If you are only doing B2B export, you should be expanding right now into selling e-commerce as well. E-commerce gives you wider range of coverage when you sell cross-border. So in B2B, you could be exporting to a fixed set of customers in the US or in the UK. With the e-commerce set of operations, you could be selling to a client in Australia, a client in Singapore, a client to Hong Kong. That gives you a wide range of exposure to customers across the globe. More exposure, more sales, more chances of survival, and overall more success. That's pretty much the power of cross-border e-commerce. So, my favorite slide from this presentation, if you look at last 10 years, the growth, the e-commerce penetration in the US, while this slide only talks about North America as a market, it has been pretty standard. The market has been growing 1.5% to almost 2% every year. In last 1 year, the growth has, in basically 8 weeks, I would say that 8 weeks from January to April, the growth has been almost 11% from 16 to 27%. That clearly implies that customers in the US are now going to buying online or have now started moving towards online. People who have not bought online forever are now starting to shop online. And there is no better time than now to be starting to sell cross-border. The source of this information is the Bank of America and the Department of Commerce report for 2020. So let's look at enough said about the opportunity. Now you know, okay, like opportunity hai, and there are customers who want to buy Indian goods. So what can Payoneer do for you as a platform? So we are a fintech solution. We allow you to accept payments from B2B customers and marketplaces. We work with dozens of marketplaces across the globe. We work with Amazon US, Amazon UK, EU, Wish, Google Shopping, Lazada, you name the marketplace, and we pretty much work with all of them. We work in the Middle East and across the globe. We have localized solutions for each market. I'll speak about them in the later part of the presentation of what are the barriers to entry into each market. Say, for example, you could be successfully selling in the US right now, but you are not successful in the UK. So what are the barriers to entry and how Payoneer helps not just as a payment platform, but beyond as a payment platform, as an ecosystem player by working with partners like Unicommerce, Shopify, Amazon, etc. to deliver you a complete solution that helps you break into each market across the globe. So Indian products have a great acceptance in the local market, like in the US, in the EU. I spoke about it in my previous slides. Indian bed sheets are a big hit. A lot of products from India, which you would have not known have acceptance outside India, are actually a hit. For example, temple belts is one of the top selling items in the UAE marketplace. That can be attributed to the Indian diaspora that resides in the UAE, that same also applies in the US. So you don't have to limit yourself to India. I will only sell in India. I'm happy right now. I'm selling to X thousand customers in India. Now is the best time to be expanding cross-border and experimenting on any channel that you have not worked so far. So let's talk about what Payoneer does as a platform and what are the capabilities that we provide as a payment. We integrate with every marketplace. When I say integrate, what I mean is you can use the same Payoneer account on Amazon US, Amazon UK, Amazon EU, Walmart, Wish, Lazada, Rakuten, Cdiscount, a lot of these marketplaces, and accept payments directly in your local bank account. You can connect the same Payoneer account in these marketplaces and all the payments come through a single Payoneer account. So primarily as a product, Payoneer offers you local receiving bank accounts in 8 to 9 geographies. When you create a Payoneer account, you get a local bank account in US, pound, euros, CADs, Australian dollars, Japanese yen, Singapore dollars, AED, etc. And these local payment methods, these local bank accounts either can be used with a B2B customer or can be updated on a marketplace. Let's take a real-time example. You are a linen seller selling on Amazon and you are based out of New Delhi, for example, and you periodically also get B2B orders from the US and you want your client to pay using Payoneer. You can share the Payoneer virtual account number with them and they can make a local bank transfer in this account number, this US dollar account, and funds are automatically transferred to you in India in INR or in US dollars. There may be customers who want to pay you using debit card. There may be customers who are like, no, I only want to pay using credit card or debit card. You can send them a payment link using the Payoneer account and they can pay you using a debit card or a credit card. E-check, something very unique to the US, very localized to the US. Like I spoke, we have localized payment option for each geography. Customers in the US can also pay you using electronic check. Last but not the least, Payoneer is a payment solution. It connects to payment gateways as well. You can connect the same Payoneer account with TooCheckout, a very popular payment gateway that integrates with Stripe, with Shopify and other web stacks your e-commerce store, which you can use to build your e-commerce store. And you can also connect the same Payoneer account to Authorize.net, etc. So the limitation is not just to marketplaces or to direct customers. If you have your Shopify store, if you're selling cross-border, yes, we can connect and we can help you link your Payoneer account. What are the benefits overall? I spoke about the features. So there is no front fee, there is no bank transfer fee, there is no marketplace withdrawal fee, etc. Payoneer is very transparent. It is exactly what you see is what you get. The very old quote applies really well to Payoneer. So we only charge a flat currency conversion fee, which is up to 2%. It's an integrated solution. You can accept payments in US dollars as well, or in euros or in pounds in your Indian bank account. It's a specialized thing that we have built only for India as a market. If you have an EFC account in India and you're like, no, I don't want funds in INR, I want funds in US dollars or in pounds, you can also get funds in US dollars or pounds in your EFC bank account in India. Platform is really fast. Funds get transferred to your local bank in 2 to 4 business days, depending on the mode of the transaction. If you get paid from Amazon, it takes up to 2 working days for the payment to reflect in your Payoneer account, and then another day for it to be credited to your Indian bank account. Fourth, and the biggest worry and one of the most prime concerns for exporters in India, FIRC, Foreign Inward Remittance Certificate. This piece of document is required by every exporter from India to close their export bills. It has been questioned from all the sellers throughout the years I've been at Payoneer. Sir, how do I get my FIRC? How can I download my FIRC? Does Payoneer provide me FIRC? How can I get it? So all these questions. So the answer is one, Payoneer gives you automatic FIRC after each and every transaction that you do. If you get paid from Amazon, you get a payment of $5,000 from Amazon. The FIRC is available in your Payoneer account, which you can download directly. You use a payment gateway like TooCheckout on your Shopify store, and the payment is processed by Payoneer. As soon as the payment is transferred to a local bank, the FIRC is available in your Payoneer account. It is something which I call as, when I speak with my sellers, as a USP of Payoneer. We understand the difficulty you face to close your export transaction with your banks. We understand the difficulty you face to close your bills, etc. So the FIRC has already have it covered. It's free of cost right now. There is no additional fee that we charge for FIRC. Payoneer is highly compliant with OPGSP RDI agreements in India, and we are registered with the RBI. Overall, the platform is very transparent. It's very simple to use, very direct. There are no hidden charges, and what you see in the emails and on the platform is what is transferred to your local Indian bank account. Having said that, we do a lot of this. We believe very strongly when we work with sellers, our idea is to help you grow. It's a very simple algorithmic equation. The more you sell, the more we get to convert, right? So our sole objective is to help you grow your e-commerce business. That's why as a payment platform, we do not limit ourselves to just currency conversion or making transfers to your local bank account. We aim at being your partner on demand when it comes to account management and cataloging, for example. Let's take an example. We work with a UK-based seller. We work a India-based seller who sells on Amazon UK, who wants to sell on Amazon UK, was not able to get a UK VAT. We refer the seller to a partner who helped them get a UK VAT, and then they can also pay their UK VAT using the Payoneer account directly. So we broke the barrier to entry by helping the seller with the UK VAT, and then again helping them go live on Amazon UK by working with the Amazon Global Selling team, and then eventually also helping them pay UK VAT using the same Payoneer account. That's the kind of support that we actually believe in, be it working with logistics partner like DHL, helping e-commerce sellers launch their Shopify accounts by working with Shopify, working with platforms like Unicommerce, Seller App, for example, helping get the maximum of their advertisement spent when they sell on a market like Amazon. We help growing the ecosystem. We help, we are determined to help you grow your cross-border business by having a partner on demand directory where you can find all these partners directly. Also by working with your Payoneer relationship, share your problem areas, what is not working for you, what is working for you, and we will help you try to find the best suitable partner in India who can help you grow your business. So if you're already not using Payoneer, if you have not tried the platform, I request all of you to create a Payoneer account, try to accept payment from your direct buyers in the US, UK, Europe, wherever they are based out of, try sending a payment request from your Payoneer account to accept payment. If you are selling on Amazon, try connecting your Payoneer account on Amazon, accepting the payments, and you can work, you can speak with the Payoneer team directly, you can speak with me or my team directly, and we are happy to help you. Open to any question and answers. If there is anything around cross-border selling, please feel free to us. Thank you.
Thanks, Kavish. Thank you for taking out time, coming and joining. And thank you for a detailed presentation. I'm seeing that your presentation has been liked and loved by many. So, which was almost a self-explanatory. And you also talked about few categories which are working well, maybe ghee per se, or maybe temple bells in the UAE. So that is really enriching content, and people love to look forward to ship those categories. So two quick questions. So because we have got another 3 to 4 minutes, and I think that you can answer two questions. So let me pick these two questions. First one is, the people wanted to know how you are different from your competitors and what competition advantage the sellers will be getting in terms of paying less commission to you. So that is the first question.
So that's a very fair question for any Indian exporter selling cross-border. So when you work with Payoneer, like I said, so we are not just a payment solution. So you don't have to restrict yourself when you come to Payoneer. Okay, Payoneer will do the currency conversion for me, etc. So currency conversion, the costing, etc., the pricing is just one part of it. With Payoneer, we also help you overall grow your business. So we understand your problem areas like VAT. like transferring funds to your dollar account in EFC account, like automatic FIRC. The team here in Payoneer is trained, is educated enough to be able to help close your export wins. So there is a lot of expertise that comes along with Payoneer. One, and two, we work with a range of marketplaces. So we understand both sides of the business. The SMB part of it, when you sell from India on a marketplace like Amazon, etc. And the other part of the business where we work with marketplaces to make the payout for your local account. So we understand both spectrums to it. We run dedicated programs that allow sellers to expand their business. So we don't limit ourselves to just payments. So we are not running a standard race where we only do payments for you. We overall want to help you grow your business. There is a consultative approach in the way we help you grow your business. So I think that's a key differentiator in the way Payoneer works. And that's one of the important reasons that you should be considering before you start using Payoneer.
Thank you. The next question for you, people are preferring banks, preferably HDFC Bank per se, or maybe ICICI Bank per se, with lesser rate of interest as compared as to you. So how you are going to deal with that challenge coming in for you? And second part to it, do you charge in terms of returns? So if a seller is returning something and then he's reclaiming the payment back to his credit card, so will you be charging the commission or maybe your percentage will a cut percentage over on the same?
Sure. So I'll just take this second question first. So Payoneer is a payout solution when you work on marketplaces. For example, you are a seller on Amazon US. You have been selling, you have your own brand of, say, for example, a beauty care brand on Amazon, and you sell on Amazon. Payoneer helps you accept payments, receive your payout from Amazon to your local bank account in India. So we do not have any role to play with the returns, with the credit card, or the charge method on your Amazon or on your cross-border business. We are not into that. We are basically a payout solution to allow you to accept payment from different marketplaces in your local Indian bank account. So there is totally no correlation between returns or your credit card being charged. We do not have a play there as a payment solution. That's the answer to the second question. Answer to the first question, a very interesting question that we get almost on an everyday basis. Banking as a channel offers you a lower currency conversion rate. So while we understand that banks offer a lower currency conversion rate, Payoneer offers you a lot more as compared to just banks. So with Payoneer, you can accept payments via credit card. You can accept payments via the Payoneer Global Wire account, which is a unique offering by Payoneer, where you can accept payments from 200 plus currencies directly. With Payoneer, you also get an option to pay your VAT, etc. So you have to look at Payoneer as a unified solution and not just a partner that does currency conversion for you. So we are not just doing the currency conversion, but also offering you a lot of value-added services, which may or may not be available with traditional banking channels. And that's overall about what the platform can do for you.
Thank you.